Okay, this is the March 12th meeting of the Conway Board of Selectmen, and we will be having a meeting, a joint meeting with the Finance Committee a little later. Our meeting is being taped by Frontier Community Access Television, FCAT, for viewing by our residents and the public later. First item on the agenda is the minutes for the May 5th meeting. Has everybody gone over the minutes? Any corrections?
I did, but my memory is not good enough to be positive as to how we voted for all of those things. It contained a long, long list of how we voted on about 100 different warrant articles. Well, not that many, but great many. And they all looked right when I read through them, but I wouldn't want to testify in court, you know, so.
Well, we don't have to do that. All we have to do is approve them.
Approve them.
So I'll make a motion, we approve the minutes.
They were great, yeah, thank you.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay.
Aye.
Next item is meetings attended by Select Board members.
I went to the Frontier budget hearing, and it was good. As we find every year, the schools spend more than maybe the towns can afford, and their goal is to keep the schools excellent, and they are really doing a good job doing that. And at the end of the meeting, somebody from Deerfield laid out a really good look at why that's a problem for towns, you know, that because of Prop 2.5, we only can raise a certain amount of money. And last year, across the district, and he was mostly doing it in Deerfield, you know, the school expenses pretty much took every penny of the legal amount they could raise their taxes.
And was that Kip Camosa?
I'm not sure who he was.
He's a selectman from Deerfield.
He was a selectman from Deerfield, yeah. Right. And he was very good. And it wasn't angry, it was just, these are the numbers, and this is a problem, and we'll have this problem this year, and we had it last year. And at some point, we need to, you know, a way around this. And that then led into a discussion of all of the things that caused the schools, you know, to have a high budget, like charter schools and things that are out of their control. And,
yeah. Okay.
Robert? Quiet week for me.
Quiet week for you, quiet week for me as well. Okay.
Wow.
All right, next item is citizens' concerns. I don't see any citizens, so I guess we don't have any citizens' concerns. Old business, we have loose dogs. Tom, we spoke about loose dogs and what we were going to do.
I have not yet had a report from Chief Wimmett on how he followed up on that. I have reached out to him, so I'm expecting to hear something that I haven't heard at this time.
All right, so we'll put this off until next week?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you. Okay, review the fiscal year 2019 proposed budget. Tom?
Yeah, do you have the budget changes sheet?
Yeah.
Is one I wanted to go over. I did also send this to Alan from the Finance Committee. I assume he distributed it to his committee.
Right.
So what I did was I plugged in to the items reducing costs, the starting balance, and all the decisions that you made last week.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And we'll see whether or not the Finance Committee concurs with those. Just recapping that OPEB was kept. That is a difference from the original budget. And that we raised the grammar school's capital request. That comes from the capital stabilization, the grammar school capital stabilization fund, so that doesn't make a difference in the bottom line. But it is it's probably going to be necessary for the project. And then I mentioned a little bit about the ambulance fund and the stabilization fund.
Okay.
Now, there were a couple of items. You had asked me to get in touch with Carolyn Ness about the possible cost of the mosquito control district. She says that to come up with a final figure, they will need commissioners, and they don't have commissioners right now, or not sufficient to come up with a proposal. She's saying she's hoping the cost will be $2,500 to $4,000 per town. So that's why I put down 4,000 as the high figure.
Okay.
That said, it is an interesting legal point that any town meeting can't bind future town meetings. Agreements that the select board makes, contracts, are binding. But decisions by the town meeting, they cannot bind future town meetings. Each town meeting is free to make its own decisions.
Mm-hmm.
So even if we did vote that, with the understanding that it would probably cost $4,000 in the third year, which we should certainly be, you know, upfront about,
mm-hmm.
We could still not do that if it turned out by the time it was time to sign a contract that it would cost more than that.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I raise what I just put down what the 2.5% raise would be. I also have one really good piece of news.
I was just going to ask you about that.
It's in my update, but I'll mention it now as well. New growth is now estimated, instead of $20,000, which we always estimate that conservatively, new growth is now estimated at $52,960.
For next year?
Yes. So that's an extra $32,960 that would have been in my original budget if I'd had that figure at that time.
Mm-hmm.
That's not to say that we should move forward to to spend it,
right.
But it does provide a little bit of flexibility and a cushion going into next year.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
So that's $14,000 in taxes or something?
No. It's $32,960 that we can add to the budget level here. So when I say a starting balance, that's now down to $60,000 or $50,000.
So that's a lot. What caused that?
It was mostly a lot came from Eversource, almost all of it, and a little bit of it came from Comcast, about a tenth of that. So we got $1.794 million as a valuation increase for Eversource, $114,000 as a valuation increase for Comcast, which of course will go up next year. A few other minor things, DirecTV, LLC, $1,300, it goes down from there. And then there's an estimated residential new growth of $950,000. All of that together is total taxable new growth for FY19, $2,862,690, making $52,960 in the new growth figure that we can apply to add on to the Proposition 2.5 to come to the FY19 levy limit.
Great.
Okay. Thank you, Tom. Next item is fiscal 2019 proposed warrant. Okay.
And I had just one change in that. I was looking it over and fine-tuning it, and I think for the purposes of what we do with our personnel and our job descriptions, I would rather call the new position for the, this is Article 17, I'd rather call it administrative assistant than clerk. Clerk
sure.
Might be confused with the town clerk, but nobody's going to confuse an administrative assistant.
That's fine.
And then I just cleaned up a few typos and things like that.
Okay. So what we're waiting for now on this is the recommendations from the Finance Committee?
Yes.
Okay.
That is it.
All right. So everything else, all the changes we made last week are incorporated in this?
Yes.
Okay.
That said, please check.
Okay.
It's never good to be the only one creating something. I need a bevy of proofreaders to make sure my fingers didn't stutter or I confused it with what happened last year or something like that. And there are now all three citizen petitions on here and the text with them.
We don't have to take any action for the new one since well, they submitted it?
You'll see I said that there is no recommendation as of March 5th. Mm-hmm. So I have put in the recommendations from the board insofar as they were made. There are several for which there were not final recommendations. And I do not have the figures from the highway department on how much it would save to do the five-year plan. There are, of course, a lot of assumptions that have to be made for that. You have to estimate how much you'll be able to get for a piece of equipment. You have to estimate how much the new piece of equipment will cost. You have to estimate the sort of average repairs that would have to be made to that piece of equipment as it got older until you decided mm-hmm. that you did have to replace it. So it's a matter of going through all those assumptions and coming up with reasonable numbers that's taking the time there.
When do you expect to get the number from the Community Preservation Committee?
Soon. Okay. The accountant was most recently busy fulfilling a state obligation to get certain figures into the state by the end of by the end of February. Mm-hmm. And now that we're into March, we're moving back to some of the other priorities we had. I expect to have them. These are approximate. Mm-hmm. The top number under, this is Article 22A,
the X's.
That would be the same number as the three that are the same in B. It's 10% of whatever the final number is. The final number depends somewhat on valuations, which Lee has mm-hmm. come out with.
Okay.
And so now the accountant has to plug that in. And the figure at the bottom, C, is a hard number, 6830. We just have to figure out where it's coming from for the motion.
Okay.
Oh, and I have been working on the motions for these as well, clarifying all of the funding sources.
Okay, so we'll be ready to sign this next week.
We could be if there are no other issues to discuss with the Finance Committee. And of course, there's Article 2 and the decision on the on any general pay raise okay. to be made as well.
Okay, so let's see. We're waiting for the Finance Committee. We have one more item before that. That's the in memoriam recommendations for the fiscal year 2018 town report. We have three nominations on that.
That's correct. So I talked to Jimmy Milton, and she came up with three recommendations for you to consider. They're Bob Langevin, Frederick Eldridge, and Walter Kirkalonis.
Okay, and Walter is the only one who served the community in terms of being a police officer.
That's correct.
Many, many, many years.
That's correct. Yeah, she said a very long time. Yeah.
Yeah, I knew Walter for a long
Walter
time.
Very well liked by
yeah,
everybody.
Yeah, very, very good man, and so was Fred. Mm-hmm. But Fred wasn't involved in town activities.
Right.
So
who was Fred Eldridge? I know George Eldridge.
He worked for Butterware a whole bunch of years.
Uh huh.
Used to see him around town. Mm-hmm. All
was he related to George Eldridge that lived
there?
George Ashfield.
They are related. They can't. I'm going to mess up if I tell you.
That's okay. I just
quiet man, Fred.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I don't think I ever met Bob Langevin.
Bob was a very, very nice fellow.
Yeah.
Again, we couldn't come up with anything for Bob or Fred for in terms of town service. Mm-hmm. Doesn't mean they didn't do any, but
right.
certainly not as much as Walt.
Okay.
Bob ran State Street, right? Or the
Sunset.
The Sunset
Trail.
Yeah,
right.
When we got married, we went down and bought a lot of alcohol for them.
Yeah. Oh, I see.
On a Sunday.
Well, you've been the longest one in town. Do you want to make a recommendation?
Yeah, I'll make a recommendation that we put an article about Walker Gomes.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll second that. That's a motion. I'll second that. So Walker Gomes will be the in memoriam recommendation.
You could get information from Kenny Womack on him, and you could get Carl's son, Mike. Gomes, you know, Mike.
Okay, yes.
They probably get your picture and they'll know.
A photo would be good, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm sure Mike can give you some more information on Walter.
So I think I heard a unanimous vote there.
Yeah, I think you did.
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, we're good. All right.
Did he die recently?
Yes, he did.
Because his house, I mean, to my knowledge, his house hasn't changed hands or anything yet. So
I think he died in August. Was it August?
Yeah.
Late fall sometimes.
He lives right up near me. And,
because I know about a month before he passed away, I talked to Veterans Services to get him new hearing aids.
Mm-hmm.
And they got him new hearing aids, and about a month later he passed away.
Yeah.
He passed away in his sleep, didn't he?
He was in the hospital.
Oh, he was? He couldn't have been in there long.
Because the ambulance transported him.
Oh, okay.
And right. I don't believe he came home.
Okay, all right. Okay. Okay, do we have the Finance Committee in?
I know that we're not expecting a quorum from the Finance Committee because a number of them could not make this time.
Okay.
We're having it early for the listening audience so that we can go to a regional meeting on funding regional schools in rural areas. We should have Alan is here, and Rory said that he might be able to make it, but not to count.
I got to see my house.
Yes.
I'm behaving myself.
Do we need Alan to speak?
Hi, Alan.
Hi, Alan.
Yeah, well, they met and made some recommendations as well. So
we recommended that we have more income in this town of tax fraud. That's our recommendation.
More income.
That's right. Not open property taxes.
Yeah.
There weren't too many areas of the budget we can really ask to be reviewed. I mean, part of the meeting I went to this past Thursday evening at the Frontier Regional School was of the the $250,000 or so that are opposing our budget increase this year, $205,000 when it comes from the school budgets.
Yeah.
Of that $205,000, over half comes from these collective bargaining agreements, another 25% on top of that comes from negotiated contracts for wages. So there really isn't a huge amount that we can push back. We're kind of stuck in a box. And of course, a bunch of fellow Finance Committee members and Select Board members who attended that did point out that Social Security is increasing at a much lower rate, and that we're hitting up against levy limits in our towns.
Mm-hmm.
And what we really talked of last week when we reviewed our budget was, our side of the budget in terms of the town itself, the increases are relatively modest. However, it's all coming from property taxes, and our assessed base in this town is approximately $251 million. So, it's the revenue side that's really, all of our rural towns here, it's a real issue.
That's right. Absolutely.
The budget that we have a hole of $92,000. We'll figure out how to close. I guess we'll be able to see more of that tonight. But there aren't a huge amount of gaping issues that we can really address. I mean, it's outside of the school. I mean, our other town budget is modest.
Yeah.
Oh, I did give one piece of good news that you haven't heard yet.
Oh my goodness, I can go for good news today. After that depressing conversation.
we have a revised estimate for new growth. We conservatively estimated 20,000 in new growth.
Uh-huh.
To add to the 2.5% to give us our next year's levy limit. Well, we're actually having 52,960 coming in.
Okay.
So that's 32,960 more than we had budgeted for.
Okay.
So that gives us a little bit more.
So we've got
comfort.
A $70,000 hole to close now, right now.
Or 60.
40.
Yeah.
60, all right.
Yeah.
All
right.
And I think I did send you the FY19 budget changes sheet. If not, you have it. You should have it in front of you.
Okay. Yes, sir, I see.
And these are the votes that the select board took in that table.
Okay.
Also with the with a couple of amendments down below. But the items reducing the deficits are all in the table, uh-huh. And together they leave. We're 34,907 in the black.
Okay.
If the finance committee would agree to those, the select board did want to fund OPEB with $10,000. It's good to have a record of putting money into it every year, even if it's not a lot of money. It's just looked at as the town is aware of and concerned with what's going on.
Okay.
And then we also had to raise the grammar school's capital request, $2,500, but that's okay, because that comes out of their stabilization fund anyway.
Okay.
So that doesn't really affect the bottom line.
Okay.
Yeah, and recapping for Andrea, we found another $32,000.
I have an extra copy of that if you want to give it.
Yeah, free money. Yeah, actually,
you need to work on it. I printed one at home and then, yeah.
I think she has one.
Oh, yeah. She has one? Okay.
Two copies.
This is what we're reading from.
Okay.
So the table is what the select board voted last time. They voted to keep the OPEB at $10,000. It's a good thing for going for loans. It increases your credit rating if you put even a little bit in every year. It shows that you're conscious of the need.
Alan, you had a meeting on Thursday night, right?
That's correct.
You're going to give us your recommendations on each article.
Oh, that was for the Frontier Regional School.
Oh, okay. Did you have a meeting where you made recommendations on each of these articles?
That is, we had a meeting on pretty much everything we did. We had some items of clarification, particularly the salary increases or not. We didn't know if the budget was inclusive of the proposed salary increases for this year or not. I guess the answer is no, they are not. Right.
No, it is not. I've tried to make that clear in the budget document,
uh-huh.
And it's also the last paragraph of the budget changes, a reminder that there's $13,247 for uh-huh. a 2.5% general
okay.
rise.
All right. So if we're quote-unquote in the black by $34,000,
And now we know that, or we expect that there will be an extra $32,907
mm-hmm.
on
yeah.
top of that,
yeah.
Due to the better figures for new growth that we have. We typically don't have the new growth figures by the time I have to come up with my budget. We typically budget it conservatively at $20,000. It came in at 52,960.
So that's 67,814 right now.
I'm sorry?
Is that 67,814
now? Yeah, in the black.
For that.
Yeah.
You mean the total?
The total of the 34.
The 34,907 and the 32,907?
It's 32,960.
Oh, 960.
So it's 65,867. I'm sorry, 67,867.
Then we got a question that you answered about the ambulance, the increase of $10,000 for fiscal year 19, which you answered because of lower reimbursement rates.
Yes, because the revenues have been going down, our original figures have been revised, but it's very clear that revenues have been going down mm-hmm. recently, and we have been subsidizing the ambulance at $15,000 per year. But in order to both fund their operating expense and have some significant amount we can put if there is additional amounts in receipts reserved into their stabilization fund, I thought it was necessary to add to their operating budget in Article 2. The excess, again, going into their stabilization fund for the ambulance, because we're not able to meet our target for what that level would be.
Okay.
But and it will fluctuate because we don't know what the receipts are going to be in any particular year.
Uh-huh.
But rather than have that be a worry for the ambulance director,
yeah.
You know, it'll just be what we either put more or less into the stabilization fund.
Yeah. About insurance, $8,200 increase. That includes the. It doesn't include workers' comp. That's just strictly liability insurance, correct?
It includes. It includes everything.
Includes everything. Okay. I mean, we came up with no exceptions or findings in this for our town budget side. We did note that a significant increase does not come from the town budget; it comes from the schools. And you know, we're concerned that because our property tax base is not increased, that means rates go up. Not a fun position to be in, but you know, as you propose, the budget balances.
And we are in the fortunate position of having sufficient excess levy capacity to be able to absorb that without cutting town operations, mm-hmm. unlike some of the other towns in the region.
Yeah, no, relatively speaking, you put money aside in OPEB, which puts us in a pretty elite company, I guess, so to speak.
Even just $10,000.
In Western Massachusetts,
yes.
That's certainly the case.
Yeah, you know, our towns aren't doing it all. But,
yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Ideally, we'd put in probably double that, but I mean, some years better than others.
I figured starting small was good.
Yeah.
And then if we can afford more, you know, we can think about that.
Mm-hmm.
It will certainly help our credit rating to put more in.
Of course.
I don't think we could put enough in to give us a top credit rating. I think all of Western Massachusetts is kind of down a notch, mm-hmm. simply because we have less economic activity,
yeah.
And therefore less chance to survive some kind of an economic shock.
Yeah.
And essentially 80% of the OPEB obligation comes from the school side,
yes, absolutely.
Not the town side.
Yeah, when I went to my training this past October, at any time you hire a teacher, think of another $1 to $2 million of OPEB 30 years down the road.
Mm. Uh-huh.
You know, there you
yeah.
have it.
That's right. It's like something that never ends.
Yeah, exactly. It's basically an inverted pyramid over our heads.
And the way they figure the obligation is worst case scenario.
Yeah.
Very conservative.
Okay. Yeah.
Which, you know, will probably not happen, but that's the way they calculate the obligation, is the total worst case scenario.
Yeah.
Let's hope they don't do the same for highways.
Sure. Yeah. Exactly.
Well, the way the state cuts things.
Yeah. Yeah.
You notice we've been slowly been going down on highway budget money every year, a little bit less every year.
Yeah, Chapter 90 money has been just about stable the last 3 years.
It goes down $1,000 a year.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which is, yeah. Of course, in real terms, it's slightly, it's a little bit more of a difference, but there hasn't been that much inflation. So,
mm-hmm.
And so over the long term, though, that can add up.
Yeah. Okay. Alan, would you go over your the committee's recommendations? We can start with Article 3.
Okay. We went over the budget side in Article 3. We didn't vote on that. We didn't vote on that in Article 3. We have a majority of all present in our committee. finance recommendation. We haven't met to talk about a lot of these, have we, Andrew, right?
Oh, okay, so...
it makes sense to hold off.
Yeah.
All right, so you don't have any recommendations tonight?
That's correct.
Okay. What's the deadline for them, Tom?
Well,
we have the 19th, right?
We, next week would be the latest I'd like to see.
Okay.
We then have to get it out for legal review and get the motions out for legal review. And we do have a month before we have to print it, and we have to send it off to the printer, but it's always good to have it done.
Did more articles come in between?
Just one.
Okay.
Yeah, that doesn't require a recommendation.
Yeah.
And the warrant, and the select board did close the warrant last week.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So. All right. So what we're intending to do is have a meeting between now. So when's our ultimate deadline? Is it the following up? Is it the 26th of March, you'd like? Because you can call a meeting of the finance committee again sometime over the next week and a half. I'll call it. You know, we'll do our line-by-line recommendation.
You know, it would have been great to have it tonight, but if you can, maybe you can meet next week and have it ready.
Can we email it to you, or do we have to do it in person?
You have to do it in person.
No, you can email it.
No,
I'll email it to you, but the meeting.
You could email it if you had any.
Yeah, you guys have a meeting,
but you can email the results to us.
The meeting, understood.
So when we went through and gave our recommendation, they were based upon the changes that Tom summarized here. Do we want to vote for the Lucas thing, and it depended upon where the money goes.
Yeah. So, understood.
So that's why Tom wanted to make sure you saw the budget changes that were sort of in the assumptions that we were making when we gave recommendations.
So, for instance, Article 6 now has a figure of $25,000 for the Conway Grammar School Capital Stabilization Account.
Mm-hmm.
That said, the Lucas unit is coming from general stabilization now, mm-hmm. so that doesn't affect the bottom line, and the number is not changed.
But in your original budget, it was coming out of, you know,
raise appropriate, and
that was the change.
And then also Article 5, the highway garage stabilization is now $50,000 instead of $100,000.
Okay.
So capital stabilization is still at $125,000. Mm-hmm. But the motion will have 25 of that coming from general stabilization instead of free cash.
Okay. I was looking for other articles here about Thomas. Any other questions you have? So the hydraulic boom lift is back in Article 11.
Ron believes he can address the issues raised last
time.
And are all of these affecting the budget, or are all these just moving money around?
You look at my budget document, it'll explain exactly what the sources are that I'm proposing. And there were $157,000 in items. There was $157,000 that came from raise and appropriate, which would increase the tax levy.
Okay.
A number of things came from stabilization funds or other funds.
Okay.
So I do try to keep that amount.
And if it says raise and appropriate, is it in your budget yet?
Yes. Everything is in.
The budget is complete.
Where it comes from.
If you take this budget changes sheet, that's all the amendments that were made to it.
Okay.
And they're all action. And what she's really asking, I think, is if all these articles are approved.
If they're all approved, we're okay.
All approved. What's the increase in tax rate? Is there an increase in tax rate?
Yeah, that's what
it's next year.
Well,
that's what they want to know.
If one of these gets voted down and it says raise and appropriate, it means that the budget changes.
Yes.
Goes down.
Yeah. But all of the changes that were in this sheet are reflected in here.
The way it's proposed right now, Tom, what's the tax rate? Increase, up, down, level?
Well, it'll certainly be up. Just to clarify one thing, the language in the warrant is all of the money articles are to raise and appropriate, transfer from available funds, or otherwise provide. So that gives you complete freedom in terms of the warrant in what you do. The motions that are made will be very specific.
Okay.
And the motions will be made based on what's in those sheets, those pages in the budget that give the sources of funds. And again, this is tweaking the sources of funds somewhat.
Okay. Well, and the dollar amounts, you know,
and the dollar amounts.
The garage stabilization, changed the Conway Grammar School stabilization.
Yeah, but the warrant is written to give us maximum flexibility.
Right.
But as we tighten things up, we try to take a lot of that from stabilization to fund these things, or from free cash.
Right.
Free cash.
Yeah. Well, and that's if you've done an initial, what is our tax rate going to look like this year? I guess that might change, like, how...
You're on the vote.
Yeah.
I do not have a final figure for that. I'm going to work with Lee on doing that. She often helps calculate that. A lot of it has to do with what the valuation of the town is expected to be next year.
Right.
So what we usually come up with is a figure that says, if the valuation were the same as it is this year, your tax rate would be this much. Mm-hmm. But because valuations are expected to go up, that's always a high figure.
Yeah.
So it always comes down a little bit from right. that figure.
Okay.
When you see that.
I mean, $240,000 roughly equates to about 90 cents per 1,000 increase in property taxes, right?
$250,000.
Yeah. I had originally calculated $1.09 sort of early on in the process.
Right.
And I think we've come back a little bit from that. So, yeah, because it's not just the $240,000, it's the amount we're raising and appropriating in the warrant itself. There's the operating budget, and then there are the more or less capital items, even though they're not all capital, but the money articles.
Yeah.
So if you add the money articles, the raise and appropriate money articles to the warrant, that's how you calculate the rise in taxes.
Okay, I might have misunderstood it. Because that's like ambulance, you have 10,000 in the budget, but then there's like a raise and appropriate 17,000 for the whatever it's called.
But that's coming from general stabilization now.
Right. Okay.
Actually, it says raise and appropriate, but it's coming
And the there's another ambulance thing in here too, Article 10. Though that comes from the money that they've gotten this year, receipts reserved. When they get money in, it goes into a fund.
But that won't affect the tax rate.
So yeah, exactly. So that's where that comes from.
Okay. Yeah, it's. I feel like it's. I mean, I'm new to the table.
Mm-hmm.
It's all right. But it's it's like hard for me to look at Article 10 and know if it's raising the tax rate or not, right? Is that...
That's what the budget's for, yeah. So...
Because... Okay.
I try to make all of that as clear as I can in the budget, but it is complex, which is why it takes a longer document to spell everything out. And I do have a draft of the motions, and I can get that out, and that clarifies where everything's coming from as well.
Thanks.
But there's a couple of tables in the budget that cover that pretty clearly, I think.
Mm-hmm. So they got a copy of your budget document in addition to the warrant.
Oh, absolutely.
You have that.
Yeah.
There's so many copies.
Yes, that's true.
There's so many copies, right?
Yeah.
Every week you get new copies. Because it's been changing.
There was one change. There was one change in the budget, and there are three extra copies right there on the table at the town office if anybody wants them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll pick them up for our meeting next week.
And then there's the changes that voted last week.
Yeah.
Yes. So yes, it has changed.
Did your board at all discuss the pay raise for town employees? Or have you not done that yet?
We want a clarification. I mean, we agree to it. We haven't, I'll take a formal vote. We agree to it. We just want to know if it was included in this budget or not. And the answer is it's not. But now that we have this information, we have a lot more comfort to make a final vote, which we'll do over the next week and a half.
And again, that figure is on the last line, and I think you have the Excel sheet that shows the different percentages as well. It's about a $3,000 difference for each half a percent.
Where did you guys find an extra $30,000? Where did that come from?
It came from new growth. So to calculate the levy limit, it's 2.5% more than the previous year, plus any new growth in the town.
Okay.
So we had a lot of new growth in the utilities, especially Eversource.
Yeah, Tom, when you went over those details, Andrea wasn't here. Would you give her those details again?
Yeah. So because it's based on the valuation of property, when somebody puts up a new house or improves a utility, that adds to the value of the property. And when I put the budget together, we only have, we conservatively estimate $20,000 typically for new growth. And then, and last year we only had $22,000. So it was good we didn't estimate much.
Right.
This year, I just got the figures this weekend from Lee saying we have $52,907 now. We're expecting that amount for new growth. So that's $32,907 more than we had, more than we estimated. So the amount that's in the budget for, that says, for instance, that we're $92,000 in the hole, you take away $32,000 from that, and we're only $60,000 in the hole. So that's good news. And it was mostly Eversource. It was $1.7 million.
Was that due to the tornado improvements?
I'm wondering why the Eversource valuation went up so much.
Is it, I don't know.
Brand new poles that they put up all over town?
I just got the figures. I haven't talked to them.
Probably part of it.
That's what I would imagine it would be from.
A bunch of poles over there.
Eversource has done some work in town for the broadband, which may have meant some new poles too.
So
not unless it's Comcast putting in. They put in their
Comcast.
Comcast is a small piece.
Comcast was only up $100,000.
That's all.
Yeah.
All right.
We'll get that next year.
Oh, okay.
But most of it will be that. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, that'll be another boost. But again, another boost just means a boost in the level at which we can tax. So you might not want to spend up to that level.
And
Conway has been very fortunate ever since the elementary school was built and an override was passed for that. Spending went back down to its original level. And so we had a tremendous excess levy capacity. So we could charge, or we could tax more each year, much more than we actually did. But we have been catching up to that. And now, over the last 10 years, now we're much closer to the levy limit each year.
Right.
We're not right up against it. Some of our neighboring towns are, which is why they have a lot of problem with the school. They really can't absorb that and so have to cut their operating budget and can't have all these, money articles for this and that.
Right.
And, OPEB is a dream for them. So
we're still a couple of years away from hitting the levy limit, right? A couple of operating budgets away.
Well, if everyone got what they wanted to, if we funded everything at the level that it was requested, we were $92,000, or call it $60,000 over the levy, if we funded things according to the original proposal. Right. So in a sense, we're there.
Right. Yeah, understood. And this comes down, we've talked about most last week at our meeting, the finance committee is, just the assessed rates are where they are, about $251.4 million, and there's not a lot of the revenues that are being generated in this town. It's comes down to the ugly burden of property taxes, which really...
Well, unfortunately, we have all these stabilization funds.
Yeah, you know, but we're picking away.
We're going to be slowly starting to come down.
Yes, we will.
Yeah, not a pretty picture.
No.
Not long term, which is why I look forward to a good capital improvements planning document.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Like, I think we noted it would be nice, you know, next year, ideally, if we could have that a capital improvements report from the committee, and hopefully that can happen sometime over the next 12 months or so. And the other would be the personnel committee in terms of, you know, the other area of concern remains, are we competitive with going wages for our respective town positions or not?
Well, I know that, and I know that we're roughly in the middle.
Mm-hmm. What does that mean?
So it's not... We're very close to the middle for most of our positions and most of our major positions.
So running with the pack.
And I had made an attempt over the last couple of years to bring up some positions that weren't at that level to that level. Mm-hmm. That said, we're at the average. You might consider competitively paying 10% more than the average or something like that. But so I'm not sure I would use the term competitive, but we're not behind anybody either. We're in the middle of the pack. That's what we were 2 years ago. That said, over the course of 2 years, I don't think our relative position has changed all that much.
You guys have anything else for us?
No, that's it.
Okay.
Thank you
for coming in. Appreciate it.
We'll see you soon.
And hopefully we can have your recommendations shortly.
So we have a question. So should we jointly meet again on the 19th, or should we just have our own meeting on the 19th?
Well, if you could meet on your own at say 6, and then we meet at 6, and we have a joint meeting at 6:30. Right. If you can get through the recommendations, and in half an hour, then we can
Thank you.
Move them all.
Okay. Great. Thank you guys for coming in.
Thank you.
See you soon.
Next item on the agenda, Tom, items not anticipated 48 hours in advance of the meeting.
I had intended to bring up a quote for the oil spill cleanup. We're not quite ready to do that yet. I'm waiting to find out whether or not we can, we might be able to save some money if we can get what's called a retraction of the oil spill designation, which we can do if, in the opinion of a licensed site professional, less than 10 gallons was spilled. Then if DEP approves that report, then if they approve that statement, then we don't have to submit a final report, which costs more money.
Then we're redesignated?
I'm working now with the consultant on that. So we may have a different quote next week.
Okay.
Right now, I will mention this while the Finance Committee is still here. If we have to do everything we have to do, we will actually need additional funds from what we have already spent. The total will be much more like $25,000 instead of $20,000. So this is one of the reasons I'm trying to cut costs as much as possible.
Yeah, you're talking about that.
Oh, that's right. That's right. I already filled it out.
Is that it?
I don't have any reason not to have that happen.
Okay.
If we don't need it, we don't need it. And that's just an authorization.
Right.
So I'm hoping that we don't have to spend it. But right now,
I'm happy not
that's,
to sign
that's
right.
the quote. But, we're going to pay about $9,000 for the initial spill.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And there's more work that goes into assessing the site than cleaning up and final assessment and report, that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
However, because everyone recognizes that it was actually a small spill, even though we didn't know how much it was at first, if we can come up with a statement, a reasonable statement that says, due to this and this, we believe it was less than 10 gallons, we might be able to catch a break.
Okay. So who makes that statement?
That would be the licensed site professional and the Board of Health.
Great.
It would probably be a joint statement to DEP.
How's our investigation progressing on this?
I was not able to check in with Ken today.
Okay. All right, next item on the agenda is the town administrator update. Tom?
Yeah, this is the briefest of all possible updates. You'll be glad to hear.
I guess it's a blank page.
Right. There is an update on the website. Our new version of our website is almost ready. We're going to committees and departments actually to review what they currently have on their current page and see if they want to change before the new site goes up. A lot of the pages are out of date. We're hoping to get good response to this.
I've gotten 2 responses already.
Oh, good. We just sent that out on Thursday. Yeah.
Yep.
So that's excellent. You saw that I changed clerk to administrative assistant.
Yep.
If you have any requests for traffic counts on various roads, the FERCOG does that on an annual basis.
Right.
They've sent out their notice requesting if anyone wants to know how many cars are going down a certain road,
Is there any need for us to have any traffic counts?
And usually Ron might ask for one or two, but we did a complete set a while back.
A couple years ago.
I happen to notice that the road conditions seem to be deteriorating real fast on the transfer station road, Old Cricket Hill Road.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe they should, you got a better idea of traffic. I'm sure you'd be shocked how many cars wink up down it because of the transfer station.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure. Yeah.
And then I just note the new growth figure.
Yeah, that's great. Okay, thank you, Tom. Okay, concerns of the selectmen. Do we have any concerns?
So I have one that I'll raise.
Oh, you do? Okay.
I mean, and I asked Tom when the right time was, but I got a call this morning from Everett Veit, who just wanted to make sure that he wanted me to tell the board that he's decided he would like to sell his garage. And he's talked to the town in the past about selling it and never decided that he wanted to sell it. So he thought that the town might be interested. He's willing to be fairly flexible on price. And I think there's some real advantages in selling it to the town, having to do with grants that we might be able to get in the case that there's an oil spill under the garage.
Why don't you have him?
So we'll talk about it next week. So I'm not bringing it up.
Yeah, just have Tom talk to him about it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Tom will gather the details and
so
we'll see what.
So Tom printed out a sheet of a realty sheet for the garage.
Right.
And I went and took a picture of it just now. So maybe we can update it with a picture and.
Right.
And.
Yeah, that's our property card.
Yeah. Yeah. So it doesn't feel like it's anything we can talk about today, but I just wanted to bring it up so that people know, or that we all know, that we'll talk about it. So
sounds great. Thank you, Robert. Mail. Okay, we got copies of our beacon. Okay, that seems to be the only one. I want to call your attention to my picture on page 11.
Oh, how did I miss that?
If you look carefully at the bottom picture.
Which are you?
Well, if you look in the middle of the picture, you'll see a young lady who's dressed in white.
Yeah.
Right to the left of her.
I'm right to the left of her.
Our left or her left?
That was the local government advisory commission swearing in for this year.
Ah.
So just, just take a
good look at that picture. Oh, there he is.
Okay.
There he is.
You're gonna have to get your.
Is that Julie Jacobs?
Magnifying glass out.
That's Julie Jacobs.
Yes, it is Julie. Yeah. Yes. See, you recognized Julie, but you didn't recognize me.
I recognized you. Bob didn't recognize.
I don't know Julie Jacobs.
Town administrator, Auburn.
So are we? Okay.
Manager.
Introduce last item.
Okay. I don't think we have any announcements. Okay, next item is, well, our next meeting is for the 19th, which is next Monday here at 6 p.m. with a Finance Committee meeting at 6:30.
Will they be coming in then? Doesn't sound to me like they're going to be.
So should we have start our meeting over in the office and then join them here?
I'll work that out with them.
Okay.
That's a good idea. Yeah.
It almost sounds to me like they may not be ready for the meeting. He's talking about not calling me next week.
At the end when he walked out, I thought he was getting the message.
We need recommendations by next week.
Yeah. If we're not going to meet him, we can meet back over there.
Yeah.
That was my only question.
Okay.
As to where the location would be.
Right. Okay. We'll play that by ear, Tom. Okay, yeah. Location is.
I'll stay in close contact with Alan.
Okay, yeah, let's see if we can get that done. Okay. Okay, anything else to come before the board? No, okay, I'll make a motion to adjourn. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.